Hi, welcome to clickmyproject.com. Project title is Privacy Preserving Raspberry Scheme over Encrypted Metering Data for Smart Grid. This process comes under the domain of Smart Grid. Smart Grid has emerged as a new concept and promising solution for intelligent electricity generation, transmission, distribution and control. The use of robust two-way communication and distributed computing technology improves the efficiency and reliability of power delivery and usage. Currently, many utility companies begin to use smart grid information system to collect real-time emerging data at their control center. A reliable communication network deployed in parallel to a power transmission and distribution grid. In this paper, we propose a privacy-preserving range query scheme over encrypted metering data for smart grid. First, we construct a range query predicate based on hidden encryption vector, specifically the session keys and searchable attributes of the encrypted data are hidden in the HBE-based range query predicate. In a requested query, we count whether session keys encryption vectors are satisfied with the range query vectors are released to the requester for decrypting encrypted metering data. Secondly, we analyze the security stance and evaluate the performance of PIR. The security analysis demonstrates that the proposed scheme can achieve user data confidentiality and privacy as well as requester query privacy. Next, I'm going to explain the data flow diagram of the process. Start the process. Next, user collect the more number of test documents and encrypt the documents using AES algorithm, advanced encryption standard. It's a symmetric encryption algorithm. Next, user forward the cipher documents to control center. Then the control center forward the cipher tags to the cloud server one. Next, the process is second session key encryption. In session key encryption should be performed using interior algorithm like hidden encryption vector algorithm. Next, the user get the vector from the user, split the keys under the vector, then encrypt the keys using HBE algorithm, hidden vector encryption algorithm. Next, user send the encrypted keys to the control center. Then the control center forward the keys to the cloud server 2. Next, the range query piece. In the range query piece, get the query from the requester. Then generate the signature using DSA algorithm, digital signature algorithm. Then the signature sent to the control center. Control center verify the signature. Then control center generate the tokens. Then the generated tokens sent to the requester. Requester get the tokens and submit the token to the cloud center 2. Depends upon the tokens, server 2 send the key and index. Request receive the key and index and send the query to the control center by index. Server 1 send the encrypted data to the requester. Finally, requester decrypt the data using the key. Finally, requester get the original data in the process. Next, I am going to explain the running procedure of the project. Start the RAM server, open NetBeans. In NetBeans, in the package, run title.java. This is the title page of the project. Browse the list of files. Click Browse. Open N1 text files, txt1.java, open, click view. These are the text files we are going to encrypted. Click next. Next, we are going to encrypt these files using AES algorithm, advanced encryption standard. Get the file, click get, generate. Files are encrypted successfully. These files are stored in D:\ eapq.java. Next, click view. These are the encrypted files. Click now. We are going to send the encrypted tiles to the control center. Click send. Now go to the package and control center.java. Receive the encrypted files. Now the control center add the unique index for each files. Then consultant center send these files, encrypted files, to the cloud server 1. Click send. Go to the package and cloud1.java. Click resume. Files are uploaded in cloud successfully. Now going to the next process. Next, the trusted authority need to create a private key and a public key for session encryption. Get the generators and get the Y value, and get the Y1 value and get Y2 value. Generate the public key and private key. And go to the user. User enter the encrypted vector X, for example 5. The session keys are split into two forms. One first form session keys are KSL. We need to encrypt these session keys. Get ciphertext 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and next. Another scripted session key is KSL. Get the random value, get the ciphertext. Now we are going to send these two session keys into the cloud center. Click send. Go to the cloudcenter.java. Click receive successfully. Now the control center add unique index for each encrypted keys. Click add. Index are added successfully. Next, the control center send the session keys to cloud server 2. Click send. Go to the package, run cloud2.java. Click receive. Keys are uploaded successfully. Next, run the requester process. Next, run the requester.java. Enter the query, for example 5. Get the requester ID randomly and generate the signature for those requester ID. This signature send to the control center. Query translator send. Go to the control center 2.java. Receive the query, verify whether there is a original user or not. True. Split the query into two forms. Generate the token. Next, they send the token to the translator. Click send. Go to the query translator requester.java. Click receive. Next, send these tokens. Send the tokens to the cloud server 2. Click send. Go to the package. Run range2.java. Receive the tokens. Add unique index for each token and send to the requester. Go to the requester.java. Click next. Receive the key and index successfully. Now requester enter the query by index. For example, type 4 as query by index. Send the query to the cloud server 1. Click send, then run range1.java in VM1 package. Receive the index and retrieve the data, text3.data. These text file only user requester share this text file only. Send the text file to the requester. Go to the requester. Receive the encrypted data, text3.txt. Next, your requester decrypt the data using the secret keys. Click next. Get the ciphertext. Choose the ciphertext. These are the ciphertext. And decrypt it, decrypted successfully. Let's get the original contact. Requesters have the data successfully. Finally, the conclusion of the project is the The privacy range query scheme allow user to store their data on cloud server in encrypted form, and range queries are executed by using cloud server computational capabilities. A requester with authorized query token can obtain the current session keys to retrieve the metering data with specific ranges. Thank you.